Hello and welcome to the course Design and Analysis of Algorithms. Today we will see how we can use recursion tree method to solve recurrences. As we discussed in the last video, making a good guess is sometimes difficult with the substitution method. Recursion tree method can be used to devise a good guess for the substitution method. Recursion trees show successive expansions of recurrences using trees. Recursion trees model the cost or time of a recursive execution of an algorithm that is composed of two parts, the cost of the non-recursive part and the cost of the recursive calls on smaller input size. A single tree node represents the cost of a subproblem, that is the recursive function invocation. To determine the total cost of the recursion tree, we evaluate the cost of the individual node at depth I, sum up the cost of all nodes at depth I, and sum up all the per level cost of the recursion tree. To see how the recursion tree method works, let's solve the following recurrence of merge sort using recursion tree method. Since the problem size is being divided into equal halves, we assume that n is exact power of 2. Before we start solving the problem, let's have a look at following properties that we will be needing while using recursion tree method. The first property is the logarithmic property. X to the power of log base y of n is also equal to n to the power of log base y of x. So the x and n have exchanged position. The proof of this is not the scope of this course. Additionally, we will also be needing this geometric series sum. If the value of x is greater than 1 in our series, we will be using this formula. If the value of x is less than 1, we will be using this formula. Given a recurrence equation, the first step is to draw a recursion tree for that recurrence equation. In this case, the n here, which is the non-recursive part, will be the root node of the tree. And the function t is called 2 times on input size n by 2. So we will have 2 children of t n by 2. So 2t n by 2 plus n will be represented as tree 2t n by 2 plus n. To find t of n, we first need to find t of n by 2. So what will be t of n by 2? We plug n by 2 in this equation t of n and we get t of n by 2 is equal to 2t n by 4 plus n by 2. So what we are doing here is to find t of n by 2, we plug n by 2 in this main equation. So if we plug n by 2 here, so this will become n by 4 plus, since we have n by 2 here, so we plug n by 2 in this n, we will get n by 2. After we have found t of n by 2, we can replace this t of n by 2 in the recursion tree. So we will have n by 2, which is the non-recursive part of t of n by 2. We will have n by 2 here. And then the recursive part is t of n by 4, which is called 2 times. So we will have t of n by 4 2 times for each branch. Now we need to find out what is the value of t of n by 4. So we plug in t of n by 4 in the original recurrence equation and we get t of n by 4 is equal to 2t n by 8 plus n by 4. After we have found t of n by 4, we replace t of n by 4 in the recursion tree. And we continue expanding until the problem size reduces to 1. Here we assume that the problem size reduces to 1 at the kth level. Once we have unrolled the recursion of the recurrence equation, as we can see in the recursion tree, we now need to find the cost of the tree. So the cost of the tree has two components. One is the cost of all leaf nodes, and the other component is the cost of all internal nodes. So we will be finding the cost of all leaf nodes separately, and we will be finding the cost of all internal nodes separately by calculating the cost at each step and then summing the cost of all levels. The cost of the leaf node is the cost of a leaf node times the total number of leaf nodes plus the cost of internal node is the sum of the cost at each level of internal nodes. We denote cost of leaf nodes as LC and cost of internal nodes as IC. Before we can find the value of LC, we need to figure out what is the value of K in terms of N. From this equation, we can see that n over 2 to the power of k is equal to 1. So n is equal to 2 to the power of k. We take log base 2 on both sides. So k is equal to log base 2 of n. Since the cost of individual leaf node is 1, we need to figure out how many leaf nodes are there at kth level. Since the number of nodes in the tree are increasing by power of 2 at each level, on k levels, we will have a total of 2 to the power of k leaf nodes. Let's plug in the value of k and solve, and we will get leaf cost equal to n. So for this problem, the total leaf costs of all leaf nodes is n. Now let's find the value of IC. At level 0, our cost is n. At level 1, our cost will be n over 2 plus n over 2, which is again n. At level 2, our cost will be 4 times n by 4, which is again n, and so on. So we will have to find for interior nodes the cost until k minus 1 levels. It is interesting to note that the total level of the trees we are assuming is that they are k. So from 0 to k, they are total of k plus 1 levels, and the total interior nodes levels are k, that is 0 to k minus 1. So they are k levels of interior nodes. So at last level of interior nodes, the cost will also be n. So IC will be k times n because they are k levels of interior nodes. We plug in the value of k and our IC will be n log base 2 of n. So our total cost for this recurrence equation will be n log n plus n, which is big O of n log n. So here we solved the recurrence equation of merge sort using recursion tree method, and our big O is n log of n. Now let's have a look at another example. In this case, we have n square instead of n in the non-recursive part. We assume that n is exact power of 2 since the problem is being divided into 2 equal halves in each iteration. Firstly, we will draw the recursion tree of this recurrence equation. N square is the non-recursive part, which will be our root here. Since we have 2 t of n by 2 here, we will have 2 children of t of n by 2. To solve t of n, we first need to find t of n by 2. So we plug in n by 2 in the recurrence equation and replace t of n by 2 in the recursion tree. So we now need to find t of n by 4 in the recursion tree. So we plug in n by 4 in the original recurrence equation and replace t of n by 4 in the recursion tree. We continue expanding until the kth level, where we are reduced to the problem of size 1. Once we get the recursion tree, we now need to find the LC and the IC, which is the leaf cost and the interior node cost. To find LC, we need to find the value of K. So N over 2 to the power of K is equal to 1. So we have N is equal to 2 to the power of K, and our K will be log base 2 of N. So there are total of 2 to the power of K leaf nodes at kth level. So we plug in the value of K and our leaf cost will be N. Now let's solve for IC. At the root level, our cost is N square. At the first level, our cost will be 2 times N square over 4, which is N square by 2. At the second level, our cost will be 4 times N square over 16, which is N square by 4. So we will continue until K minus 1 level. K minus 1th level, which is the last level of interior nodes. At that level, our cost will be N square divided by 2 to the power of K minus 1. As we can see, here our multiplying constant is 1 over 2 to the power of 0. Here it is 1 over 2. Here it is 1 over 4 square, 1 over 2 square, and so on. So it is increasing by 2 in the denominator. So at k minus 1 level, our cost will be n square divided by 2 to the power of k minus 1. To find the total interior cost, which is IC, we add all the cost of each level and we get this. Here we take n square as a common, and we can see the series of the geometric series of 1 by 2. So recall the formula that we discussed in the previous slides. In this case, the value of x here is less than 1. So the formula we will be using is 1 over 1 minus x. X in this case is half. So we plug in the value and solve. So our IC will turn out to be 2 n square. So our total cost will be 2 n square plus n. And we have two terms, n and n square, in the total cost. So our big O will be which one ever has the greater power of n. So in this case, our big O will be n square. Now let's solve a slightly different recurrence equation. We have t of n is equal to 3t n by 4 plus n square. In this problem, the problem size is divided by 4 in each iteration. So we assume n to be exact power of 4. Firstly, we will draw the recursion tree of this recurrence. N square is the non-recursive part, which will be at the root. Here, the t of n by 4 is being called 3 times. So we will have 3 children of t of n by 4. So whatever number we have here will be the number of children in each step. To find the value of t of n, we need to find the value of t of n by 4. So we plug n by 4 into the original recurrence equation and we get the following recurrence equation. Using this recurrence equation, we replace the t of n by 4 in the recursion tree. We now need to find t of n by 16 in the recursion tree. So we plug in n by 16 in the original recurrence equation and we get the following recurrence. Using this recurrence, we can replace t of n by 16 in the recursion tree. We continue expanding until the kth level where the problem size is reduced to 1. Once we have got the recursion tree, we now need to find the cost of this tree. To find the LC, we first need to find the value of k. In this case, n over 4 to the power of k is equal to 1. So we have n is equal to 4k. We take log on both sides of base 4. So k in this case will be log base 4 of n. Now, how many leaves will be at kth level? Since each level, the number of nodes are growing by order of 3. So at kth level, we will have total number of leaves equal to 3 to the power of k. So we plug in the value of k. So we have 3 to the power of log base 4 of n. And using the logarithmic property that we saw on the previous slide, we can replace 3 and n or exchange 3 and n, and we will get total number of leaf cost to be n to the power of log base 4 of 3. We are using this logarithmic property because we want our complexity to be in n. After we get the value of LC, now let's solve for IC. At level 0 or the root level, our cost is n square. At level 1, our cost is 3 over 16 n square. At level 2, our cost is 9 over 256 n square, and so on until k minus 1 level. So we can see the pattern of 3 by 16. So at k minus 1 level, our cost will be 3 over 16 to the power of k minus 1 n square. So what is the total IC? We sum up all of this cost at each level. So our IC will look something like this. We take n square as common. So we have a geometric series of sum of 3 over 16. Since 3 over 16 is less than 1, so we will use the formula 1 over 1 minus x, where x is 3 over 16. We plug in 3 over 16 and we solve. So final answer of IC will be 16 over 13 n square. Our total cost will be n to the power of log base 4 of 3 plus 16 over 13 n square. To find the big O of this problem, we have to look at the power of n in both terms. We know that log base 4 of 4 is 1. So we can say that log base 4 of 3 should be less than 1. So in the first term, the power of n would be slightly less than 1. In the second term, our power of n is 2. So that is a bigger number. So our big O in this case will be n square. So now let's have a look at a slightly difficult and interesting problem. Here the recurrence equation is t of n is equal to t n by 4 plus t n by 2 plus n square. So we have two different t terms. Firstly, we will draw the recursion tree of this recurrence equation. N square is the non-recursive part, which will be at the root. We have 1 of t of n by 4 and 1 of t of n by 2. So we will have two children, 1 of t of n by 4 and 1 of t of n by 2. To find t of n, we need to find t of n by 4 as well as t of n by 2. To find both, we will plug n by 2 and n by 4 in the original recurrence equation, and we get the following recurrences. Once we get these recurrences, we plug the value of t of n by 4 and t of n by 2 in the recursion tree. To solve level 2 of the recursion tree, we need to find t of n by 4, t of n by 8, and t of n by 16. So we plug these values in the original recurrence equation and we get the following recurrences. We plug these values of t of n by 16, t of n by 8, and t of n by 4 in the recursion tree. Expand until kth level, where we are reduced to the problem size of 1. To make things easier to understand, you will note that the equation of t of n of 4 is written again. That is because we will want to keep track of how many equations are required at each level. At level 1, we needed 2 recurrence equations. At level 2, we needed 3 recurrence equations, which although we have computed t of n before. We want to keep track of this to find what the pattern is emerging here. In this problem, the n is divided into 2 different pieces, so the tree shape will not be a complete binary tree. On one side, where n is divided by 4 in each iteration, the leaf node will be reached in less number of levels as compared to the right side, where the n is divided by 2, which will go deeper down. This is because if we are dividing n by 2, it will take longer to reach the leaf node as compared to if we are dividing n by 4. Since we want to find k, which is the height of the tree, we are only interested in the deeper side of the tree, which comes from t of n by 2. So we will see what is the pattern emerging. So in the first level, it is t of n by 2. In the second level, it is t of n by 4, and so on. So at the kth level, we will have a pattern of n over 2 to the power of k. Once we have this tree, we want to find the LC and the IC. To find LC, we will need to find the value of k. So we have n is equal to 2 to the power of k. So k will be log base 2 of n. Since children are spawning in this tree, so at kth level, we will have 2 to the power of k leaves. Plug in the value of k and we get the leaf cost to be n. Now to find the value of IC, the cost of the root node or level 0 will be n square. Cost of level 1 will be 5 over 16 n square. Cost of level 2 will be 25 over 256 n square. So a pattern of 5 over 16 is emerging. So at k minus 1 level, we will have 5 over 16 to the power of k minus 1 n square. So the total internal cost will look something like this. We take n square as common and we have a geometric series of 5 over 16 summation. Again, 5 over 16 is less than 1. So we will use the formula of 1 over 1 minus x. X is 5 over 16. We plug the value in and we find the value of IC, that will be 16 over 11 n square. So our total cost will be 16 over 11 n square plus n. And the big of this problem will be n square. Let's have a look at another complex recurrence equation. T of n is equal to t of n by 3 plus t of 2n by 3 plus n. We will first draw the recursion tree for this recurrence equation. N is the non-recursive part, that will be the root. Then we'll have 1 of t of n by 3 and 1 of t of 2n by 3. So we will have two children. One is t of n by 3 and one is t of 2n by 3. Now, to solve t of n, we need t of n by 3 as well as t of 2n by 3. So we plug in the value of n by 3 and 2 of n by 3 in the original recurrence equation, and we will get the following recurrences. We will use the result of these recurrences and plug it in to our recursion tree. At this stage, we now need to find the value of t of n by 9, t of 2n by 9, and t of 4n by 9. We plug the values of n by 9, 2n by 9, and 4n by 9 in our original recurrence equation, and we get the following result. We can use this result to plug it back in our recursion tree. We continue to expand until the kth level with the problem size is reduced to 1. Because of the nature of this problem, one side of the tree will be deeper than the other. We are only interested in the deeper side of the tree. On one side, the problem is being divided by 3. On the other side, the problem is divided by 2 by 3. In this case, 2n by 3 will lead us to the deeper side of the tree. So we will see what the pattern is emerging. On level 1, we have t of 2n by 3. On level 2, we have t of 4n by 9. So at kth level, we will have 2 over 3 to the power of k n. Now that we have our recursion tree, we will find LC and IC. To find LC, we need to first find the value of k. In this case, n is going to be 3 over 2 to the power of k. Solve for k and we get k equal to log base 3 over 2 n. Since two children are spawning from each node, at kth level, we will have a total of 2 to the power of k leaves. We plug in the value of k and our LC will be n to the power of log base 3 over 2 of 2. Now let's look at the IC. At level 0, our cost will be n. At level 1, we add up the 2 and our cost will again be n. At level 2, our cost will also be n. So what the pattern emerging is that at each level in this problem, the cost is n. So we have a total of k levels of interior nodes, that is from 0 to k minus 1. So our IC will be n times k. We plug in the value of k and our IC will be n log n. Here the log is base 3 by 2. So our total cost will be n to the power of log base 3, 2. Sorry, n to the power of log base 3 by 2 of 2 plus n log 3 by 2 of n. Here in the two terms, we have n to the power of 1.5. Here we have n log n. So it's really difficult to decide which side is bigger when we want to find the value of big O. So in this case, we say that big O is ambiguous and we cannot find big O using recursion tree method. As we have seen, recursion trees are best used to generate good guesses. These guesses can be verified later by using substitution method. So the example in the last slide, which had an ambiguous case of big O, we can use both of the terms as guesses and apply substitution method, and we can figure out the actual solution to that problem. So if you try it out, you will find that n log n is the solution to the problem in the previous slide. A small amount of sloppiness can be tolerated since we are just generating a good guess. The geometric series we are using was for infinite series, but we were applying that on a finite series which stops at k. So that is our first sloppiness. Then we are assuming n to be the exact power of 2, 3 or 4, but in actual problems n does not have to be a power of 2, 3 and 4. Furthermore, if you see in the last two problems where we had two different terms of t, the tree shape is not complete tree. One side it is deep, the other side it is shallow. Our assumption is that the tree is complete. So we are summing up the interior level cost of each level. So our cost will not be accurate since at levels lower down the trees will not be full. So there will be a fewer interior nodes as compared to nodes at a upper levels of the tree. Similarly, when we are counting leaf nodes, there will be less number of leaf nodes as compared to the other problem. By carefully drawing out a recursion tree and summing the cost, recursion tree method can be used as a direct proof of a solution to any recurrence. Here are some practice questions that you can try at home. Solve these following recurrences using the recursion tree method. I hope you have enjoyed this video and have learned how to apply recursion tree method to solve recurrences. Thank you and have a nice day.